chicken nuggets. It's me, Crushing Carl. And welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl.
And your co-host, Assy. Where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Hey there! Like I said, the name is Crushing Carl. Why is it Crushing Carl? Because I'm Carl, and I like to crush things. Ah! Don't try that at home. If I could describe myself in three words, it would be 1. Determined. 2. Headstrong. 3. Jackhammer. Here at Grow TV, I believe in 2 things. 1. Protein powder is the only thing that fuels me. And 2. Lifting things over my head is the only thing that brings me joy.
Hey, Carl.
Cassie, I'm not sure who you're referring to, but my name is Crushing Carl, the sole protector of my home, Planet Liftness, and the son of Sir Lifts-a-Lot.
What are you talking about?
Cassie, I'm trying to do a character. Just roll with it, please.
Okay, so Crushing Carl?
Crushing Carl!
Right, Crushing Carl. So what do you do for fun?
What do I do for fun? Usually I have fun flexing in front of the mirror, throwing bad guys into outer space. And on the weekends, I like to drink a frappuccino and watch romantic comedies till I cry.
Cool. So what are your gifts?
How much time do you have?
At least 3 minutes.
Well, I speak 13 languages, balance a ladder on my chin, and also bend any metal on the planet.
Really? Any metal?
Any metal.
Really? Because I have this titanium tennis racket, and I was curious if you could...
I mean, I could, but I was kind of resting today, because leg day.
I mean, if you can't do it, I get it.
I can do it!
All right, let's see it.
All right. Any metal, I said.
How's it going?
Great! Just warming up. Just warming up. Gotta warm metals up before you can bend it.
You can give up if you want. There's no shame in being wrong. Whoa. Are you okay?
Oh. Yes. I'd like 2 burgers with an ostrich, please.
Come and sit up. That must have hurt a lot.
Just a little. It only hurt just a little bit.
How many fingers am I holding up?
Green.
What?
Wadagabagabag.
Maybe if I hit him with this, things will go back to normal.
I mean, unicorns, is it a horse? Is it a rhino? I mean, come on, I don't know.
Can't get worse than this.
Hey, Cassie.
Hey, Carl. How are you feeling?
I mean, like $1,000,000.
Really? That's great.
I think I'm not cut out to be a tough guy, though.
What do you mean?
Well, Crushing Carl seemed like a good idea at the time, but having real strength just ain't my thing.
Yeah, muscles and physical strength take a lot of hard work, and it's not for everyone.
Yeah, but maybe there's another type of strength I could have.
What do you mean?
Wasn't there a story in the Bible where a guy gives people strength to do really cool things, even though they may not be the biggest and strongest people?
Sure, there's plenty, but I'm thinking of the story of Joshua and Jericho.
Is that the one where Jonah gets eaten by a big old fish?
No, that's Jonah and the big fish.
Right.
Well, God had promised Joshua that Jericho would be their city. God had called them to take over the city, but it had a big wall around the whole city of Jericho.
So they gotta climb it, right?
Not quite. God tells them to walk around the city for 6 days.
Just walk?
Yep, and they gathered 7 priests with 7 trumpets as well. And on the 7th day, they were told to walk around the city 7 times. Well, this is where it gets crazy. The huge walls that surrounded the city of Jericho, they fell.
Wait, how'd they fall? Did they hit them? Wrecking ball? Earthquake? Walls just don't fall by themselves.
You're right. Walls just don't fall down without something strong pushing them down.
So what was it that knocked them down?
Well, because the people were being so obedient and patient with God, God gave them the strength to knock down those huge walls without even laying one finger on them.
Wow! So the strength God gave them wasn't like a muscle strength, but a different kind of strength. Something better.
Yep. God proved to them that if we listen and are obedient, God gives us extraordinary strength.
Whoa! You just said it! Our big idea!
Today's big idea is God gives us extraordinary strength.
So on the count of 15, we're gonna say it really loud. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. God gives us extraordinary strength. Good job, everybody. You did it.
So, do you think you're done with crushing Carl?
Yeah, I think I moved on. Turned over a new leaf. Said no one.
Crushing Carl here. Crushing Carl can never die. Crushing Carl is immortal. He can never stop me as long as I'm on God's green earth.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of...